I think everybody would do well on a plant-based diet. But for some people, like I work in the Marshall Islands doing research on diabetes, and in that area, they're very dependent upon fish. So it's fish and plants primarily. And to say, well, you know, eating fish is not ecologically sustainable, so you shouldn't be doing it, wouldn't work very well in that area. So there are some places in the world where it makes sense to include some animal-based foods. And I, you know, we can see the transition starting to happen. We're in the early stages, but I think even people who are meat eaters are looking to eat a little bit more in a manner that's a little bit more ecologically sustainable. And so they're open to trying some of the plant-based options more than they might have been 10 years ago.
So how do you view someone that just has what's called, you know, a balanced diet, meat, vegetables, et cetera, versus a vegetarian versus a vegan?
How do I view them? I mean,
in terms of like, not the person, but in terms of the health outcomes, really is what I mean. I'm sorry.
Oh, well, there's not even a question about that, because we have several studies. We have a study in the United States that's been following 96,000 people for years, well, since 2002. We have another one in the UK that's been following people since 1996. We have another one in Taiwan, and the one in the UK is about 69,000 people. And then the one in Taiwan is there's one that's 12,000, another that's about 6,000 people. And what we've been doing is following similar health conscious individuals who essentially they exercise the same amount, smoke the same amount, you know, we control for alcohol intake, for all of those lifestyle factors. And we've been looking at their health outcomes. And, you know, we've been having literally dozens and dozens of research articles published on the findings. And so what they're comparing in the two, the American and the UK study, is omnivores versus semi-vegetarians versus pesco vegetarians, which are people that are vegetarian plus fish, versus lacto-ovo vegetarians versus vegans. And that's the same in the UK and the States. And then in Taiwan, it's just vegetarians versus non-vegetarians. And basically what they found is that, well, in the Adventist Health Study 2, the vegans had about a 15% lower mortality than the omnivores, than similar health conscious omnivores. In Epic Oxford, it was about 32% less heart disease. In the Adventist Health Study 2, the vegans had 75% less hypertension, 62% less diabetes, and 52% less kidney disease. In Epic Oxford, there were 19% less cancer. In the Adventist Health Study 2, it was 16%. In Epic Oxford, 40% less cataracts, 72% less diverticular disease in the vegans versus the omnivores. And the vegetarians were somewhere in between. And lots of findings in Taiwan as well, less heart disease, less hypertension, less diabetes, and so on and so on. And so it's been very consistent in all of these studies when we compare fairly, looking at, you know, a controlling for all potential confounding variables, that the vegans, in terms of chronic degenerative disease, do the best. Lacto-ovo vegetarians in the middle, and omnivores the worst.
Yeah, also vegans, I mean, how does anyone figure that out? A vegan doesn't eat the same thing as another vegan.
Oh, no, that's no question. No question.
All of the be very different. But
yeah. And vegan, all vegan means is that they're not consuming animal products. And so there are all kinds of different levels of quality vegan diets. I mean, some vegan diets are potato chips and Coke. And some vegan diets are, you know, whole plant foods, which, of course, people who eat whole plant foods will do a lot better than people who are eating junk food vegan diets. But overall, so they're, you know, lumping people in a category based on what they include. So the omnivores include, you know, animal products. The pesco vegetarians include all plants plus fish and dairy products, and lacto-ovo vegetarians, dairy products and eggs, and vegans, no animal products. And so it's, you know, and there are differences. For example, in the U.S. study, the diets are slightly higher quality than they are in the U.K., for example. They're more a little bit more health conscious. But generally, the way that they try to control for it is they're selecting health conscious populations, and the omnivores are health conscious. And as a matter of fact, they've looked at in both the UK and the US, the whole cohort, how they compare to the general population, and their rates of death and disease are about half what they are in the general population.